In the previous video, we have seen linked list implementation using arrays in ascending order. How you can arrange the data without moving the data, how you just by making the pointer manipulation, how you can make the data to be in ascending order. In this, we'll be seeing how to do it in the descending order. So, if you see this, the first data starts. Here is the biggest element. Since descending order, it starts from biggest to smallest. So here, largest to smallest. So this is the starting point. So 120 is the largest element. So here, the next two, in order to find the next element, lesser than this, what we have to do is, you have to go to 10. Where is it? It is here. So this you have to go. Now, after this, you can find the next element in 11. So here, from 11, you go to the next field, and you have to go to 9 in order to get the next smallest element. So here it is 90. Then after this, you have to go to 22. So here, 80. So here, the next will be, you can next element, you can find it in 6. So here, so the next element, you can find it in the location 5. So here, then 8, the next will be 8. And then from here to 1, you have to go to the 1. That is, from 1, you can go to the 40. After 50, it is next small is 40. Then 7, you can find the next small element, which is nothing but 30. So here, from 7 to 30. Then from 30, the next smallest element, you can find it in location 4, which is nothing but 20. So here, then you have to go to 0, where you will find the smallest element. Then finally, with this, the list is over. So we write in the next field to be nil. So this is how you traverse the element in this linked list. One thing is, the drawback with the linked list is, you cannot search in the middle. So for example, if I want to find the element, whether 60 is in my array, in my linked list or not, then what you have to do? You have to catch this starting point, and then according to the pointer, you have to move from here to, you check whether, since our search location is 60, you have to check whether 60 is equal to 120, whether this is a 60 element. No. Then you have to move to the next pointer, go to 10. Then you check whether it is equal to 60 or not. No. Now you find this 11, and then you again check 60, then 9, here it is not equal to, then 2, here also it is not equal to, then 6, not equal to, then 5. Now it is equal. Then only, now you say it has matched, and you can return the index of that particular value in the array. So the drawback, if you see this, you have to search the whole thing. It is not, even if using array you are implementing the linked list, so you have to search like that only. You cannot just like that get the element 60 or get the searching element. You have to go through from the starting point and move through the next pointer, next locations, and then you have to match and then find the answer. So what happens here is, in array is a random structure, whereas linked list is not a random structure. It is strictly a sequential data structure. So if you see that, the advantage, what is the advantage of a linked list? The advantage of a linked list is, they are dynamic in nature, which allocate the memory when required. That is, this talks about the pointers. In a pointers linked list, you can keep on adding. So we will come to this point when we are discussing about the linked list using pointers. Here, insertion, this point is good. Insertion and deletion operation can be easily implemented. That's now we have seen. When I want to insert, just manipulating the pointer is enough. There is no need for moving the data. Same with deletion also. Then using this linked list, you can implement the stacks and queues. Then this linked list reduces the access time. This is for even if it is okay, but still you have to search the whole of the linked list in order to get your data. The disadvantage of linked list is, the memory is wasted as pointers require extra memory. What do you mean by this? Here, along with the data field, information field, you need the next field where you store the pointers. So if you have 10 elements in the data, the 10 elements, 10 next field also is necessary, which means 20. In place where you need only 10 elements, you need another 10 in order to store the memory locations. So it is a double, the extra memory is needed for storing this. No element can be accessed randomly. That is what I have said just now. It has to access each node sequentially. Reverse traversing. If you want to go back, reverse traversing is very difficult in the linked list. Linked list are used to implement stack queues. From the applications where it is in real time it is used to implement stack queues, graphs, etc. And then a very good example is web browsers, where it creates a linked list of web pages itself. So you keep on visiting so many web pages, all those things will be kept. If you see that visitor places, so that when you check history, yes, in history all these things are stored. So in what order you are seeing, all those things will be stored in the history traversal of a list, or press back button or the previous node data is fetched. If you want to go to the previous whatever website you have, you just press the previous button in the browser, you can go to the previous page what you have seen. So this is a very good example of a real-time linked list implementation.